Hello everyone, this is Joseph. Today I'm announcing some very exciting news from Mego. Mego's Wave 12 list has dropped, and it's huge. I mean, this is some great, exciting news from Mego. And if you're wondering, where's Mego Wave 10 and 11? Just to clear some things up, Mego Wave 10 has arrived at certain retailers and sellers online and stuff like that, and there should be shipping very soon. I'm seeing them on eBay and stuff, so hopefully that gets into people's hands very quick, because I'll be doing reviews on Wave 10 and 11. And to clear Wave 11, Wave 11 is going to be released around late February or so. We got the Frankenstein coming, the Bride of Frankenstein, Teen Wolf, and a couple other things. And that'll be expected around early this year sometime. I'm not sure exactly the dates because they can change and stuff. So that's Wave 11. Now, Mego's Wave 12. This was exciting because now when I pre-ordered or looked at the Mego Wave list from, like, you know, sellers. Now, if you're looking for Migos, please contact Frank Wojo. He is on Facebook. He has a outstanding review base. He has a Facebook page called Absolutely Retro, and you can contact him there if you're interested in pre-ordering. He's got fantastic prices, fantastic shipping. He is known in the Mego community for his outstanding packing, and he loves what he does. He knows what people want, and he makes sure that he packs them with kids' gloves, you know. So if you're interested in pre-orders and stuff, please check out Frank Wojo down in the description below. I'll put all of his links and stuff down below. Now, Mego's Wave 12. Now, when I saw Mego Wave 12, I was a bit shocked at first. Because when it was released as a list, there's only four characters. There was the Flash, the Green Lantern, and I'm pretty sure the Riddler, and then the Avatar character, the Last Airbender. And I was thinking, that's very short for a wave. Until in a couple days from a couple days ago, Mego Ambassador, if you're not a member there, I'll leave the description down below if you want to join. There was a news drop. It was like a it was a bomb. Many characters were announced, and even I just found some news today about a change, so that's awesome, and I'll tell you that later on in the video. So for Mego Wave 12, they announced a huge new list. Now there is those four characters in the Wave 12 assortment already. But let me tell you what they've added on. So let's get right into this. The first two figures I want to put on this list that we've all been waiting for, and most of the Star Trek fan base, McCoy and Scotty. That is great news, Mego. We've been wanting those figures for a long time, and we're finally getting them this year, and that's awesome. And that will finish up the original series crew. And some other news about those two figures. Dr. McCoy will have a medical shirt instead of his classic, you know, blue shirt, and he will have a new head sculpt along with Scotty, which is very surprising because the two original Mego sculpts were really good, so I'm very eager and excited to see how those look like. Obviously, I don't have no pictures to show you of how these look. Just please join the group, and you'll see some reveals and stuff later on in the months. Now to move on to some other characters, we have a Flocked Fly, and I do have a picture for this. It is right here. That is the Flock Fly. That figure is very interesting. A lot of people were suggesting it when it was originally supposed to come out. And now we got a Flock Fly, which Mego is listening to their fan base. And that's pretty cool they're doing that, because a Flock Fly is a really cool idea. I'm not sure if he'll have clothes. I'm not sure, but we'll see. Now we're going to move on to another character. They're doing more Universal Monsters, and I'm glad they are because I love that line. It was announced they're doing a Universal Wolfman. I'm not sure how this looks. But I'm imagining it might be based on the Lon Chaney Jr. classic version. I'm not sure, but hopefully we get that version because it's obviously my favorite. I'm very eager to see that Wolfman. I'm not sure how it's going to be revealed, but we'll see. Now, there's one character I have been wanting. This is awesome. I've seen this character suggested many places and as a license. Young Frankenstein Igor. Or it's pronounced Igor. I can't tell you how excited I am for that choice. That is such a brilliant move. And there's some explaining why they've done it licensed. But Mego has moved on to Fox. They worked out a deal with Disney and Fox. And here's the news. Originally when Mego was rolling out in Target days, they were supposed to release Planet of the Apes figures. Now what prompted them not to, they couldn't, is when Disney and Fox merged. I'm not sure when that was, but it halted them not to do it. They couldn't do it. And for years, Joel, the president of Mego, he went after the Disney and Fox stuff, and we finally been able to do that. I'm not saying we, but them. They got Planet of the Apes. Planet of the Apes are coming back. I'm not sure what characters and stuff, but I do know that he said that they got the full license, all the movies, the TV show, and stuff like that. So that's amazing, because they are releasing two new ape figures. Now they're reproductions. Now the reason that is they didn't have enough time to sculpt or make new ones, because they're wanting to make modern ones. But right now we are getting a reproduction Cornelius and a reproduction Dr. Zaius. These are based on the original classic Mego ones. I'm not sure how they look, but I'm assuming they'll look great. So I'm very excited Planet of the Apes is returning, because it is such a landmark for Mego, and it's such a great line that I love. I have, you know, here's my Cornelius, and I'll be glad to get more of these guys, because I absolutely love Planet of the Apes Migos. And I do know some news. Mego is coming back to Target around the second quarter, and there will be Planet of the Apes figures. I'm not sure what's going to be all there, but we'll wait and see the news officially from Mego. And back to Young Frankenstein, I think I saw this said by Dr. Mego, that they're making a Dr. Frankenstein in the line. That is really cool, and hopefully they'll do a Peter Boyle creature. That'll be awesome, or monster, but you know. So that is Young Frankenstein. That's such a mind blower to me. That is awesome. And then we have another Disney license aid that they're doing, the Rocketeer. Now, from information I know, that he'll have no removable helmet, it'll just be the helmet. I'm not sure how it's going to look, but I'm assuming it's going to look pretty cool. I'm not really interested in the Rocketeer, but I think for the fans who wanted one, I think that's pretty cool. And then there is a Star Trek alien coming, is the Salt Monster. Now, I'm not sure it's going to be based on the Diamond Select version of the Salt Monster, but I'm assuming it's going to be more Mego-y. It's not going to be too much detailed. But there's a Salt Monster coming in the wave. There is the Son of Frankenstein. And I'm assuming it's going to be the Boris Karloff head sculpt that they're doing, and just have the furry coat on and stuff. And I'm obviously getting that version as well. Oh, there is a new Stan Lee action figure coming out. It's called the Web Hands variant. It's where he's like this. I haven't seen the figure. There's no news about the figure yet. But I'm pretty sure it's based on Stan Lee, where he, like in some photos, he's like, you know, like that, you know, at the photographers and stuff. So I'm not sure when that's how it's going to look like, but we'll see. Oh, I got one more character I forgot. Sorry if my memory's a bit blurred, but two new characters were added on the Wave 12 today. There was Cornelius, I just announced, and then there was another, Apollo Creed. Now, Apollo Creed was shown at Toy Fair, I believe, in earlier this year or something. There was no photos allowed, but I did see one from online somewhere. But it looks really good, and they're finally adding on Apollo Creed to the list of Wave 12, and that's very exciting for the Rocky fans. I'm assuming since they put Rocky in Walmart stores, the sales have gone up, so allowing them to move on to Apollo Creed, which is pretty cool. I will be reviewing every single one of these figures when they arrive. I got Wave 10 on the way, I got Wave 11 whenever that shows up, and then Mego Wave 12, there'll be a huge review list to do, and I'm very excited for all those. So everyone, that wraps up the list for Wave 12. Let me know your opinions, comments down below about this. And if you're looking for Migos, please contact Frank Wojo down below. If you want to see sneak peeks and stuff, I recommend you joining Mego Ambassador down below, and you can see some reveals and stuff like that, so that's cool. All these stuff that you need to know are down in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoy the video or the content in general, please hit that subscribe button and turn on your notification bell so you can be notified when my videos go up first. And like this video if you want to. I'm not telling you to, but you can do it. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next video coming up soon. Goodbye.